entries for my new diary. At my father's court, you can be sent to the tower or have your head chopped off for saying what you think, or choosing the wrong friends, or practicing the wrong religion. Despite the danger, I promise that I shall tell only the truth in these pages. Truth is, I am the Invisible Princess. Perhaps I should feel lucky I was not banished from court forever when my mother was beheaded. But I am still foolish enough to long for my father's favor.
Don't be a fool, man. I crush you like a grape.
Will he ever forgive me for being the daughter of a witch? Will he ever see me for who I truly am?
Blasted legs.
Perhaps today's not the best day for a ride.
Dear Queen Catherine, it's only because she insisted the royal children be together that I'm here at all.
Do you think I should retire?
I do not envy the attention he receives.
Speak up, Edward.
Father finally got the male heir he wanted.
To the hoist!
Yet he demands so much of him. Then there is Princess Mary.
Father is in no condition to ride at all. We must put a stop to this.
Never stand between the king and what he desires, Mary.
I am convinced she remains a Catholic, despite Father's decree that we are Church of England now. That she fears me as a rival? But Edward is the heir, then Mary, and I'm lost. I doubt that I shall ever become queen, though that does not stop me from wanting it.
Against the French.
Here, here.
Princess Elizabeth will play one of her own compositions for your majesty.
Sing them, my dear.
If it pleases you, Your Majesty. Robin clad in green came to see the Queen, and sitting by the throne, two princesses were shown. Hey, nonny, nonny, hey, nonny, 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 nay. One in shadows glowed, despite her lack of gold. The other in the sun looked verily so glum.
Enough! You dare compare yourself to your sister? You put yourself ahead of Mary for the throne?
That is not what I meant, Father.
Go. Until you know your place, you are banished from this court.
Take another bath. had one 3 weeks ago. Besides, no one sees me here.
It's not so bad. Surely there are some things you like about Hatfield.
One, no fleas. Two, lots of juniper and bayberry twigs for cleaning my teeth. Three, very few rats. Four, the air does not smell quite so awful, since the floor rushes stay clean, because there are no people here. I'm so lonely. It's from the Queen. I asked her to write to the King on my behalf. The campaign against the French is going well, and he hopes to return to England in the fall. He insisted I return to court to be with the other children. Oh, fabulous Queen Catherine. I knew she would help me if she could.
We will start packing immediately, right after your bath.
I'm going home. I'm going home. Oh, perfume.
You will smell so sweet.
To tell you.
Like what?
Like the ghost is back.
Catherine Howard?
I heard her myself. She cries nightly in the long gallery.
There must be something we can do to allow her poor spirit to rest.
Psst. Don't sneak up on me like that. I thought you were the ghost. Did you bring the kittles?
Catherine was a fine playmate to us, but too young for the Queen, really.
That's why she's come back. She does not know who she is anymore. We have to play kittles with her again to remind her of her true nature.
I have known 5 of my father's 6 wives. Catherine of Aragon, Mary's mother, dead. Anne Boleyn, my mother, beheaded when I was 2. Jane Seymour died after giving birth to Edward. Anne of Cleves divorced because she was childless. Catherine Howard beheaded. And now Catherine Parr.
He likes Catherine's, does he not?
It's dangerous to be liked by my father. Died, beheaded, divorced. Died, beheaded. I do not think I could stand it if anything should happen to Catherine Parr, too.
Have you no swords left, Princess Mary? Whenever I play cards, I think of the man our father caught cheating. His hand chopped off. Just like that.
Your costume for the mask, Elizabeth. Strange that you should choose to be a swan, sister. Surely a hare would have been more appropriate. Your mother was so fond of them.
Hares are the sign of a witch, are they not? You think to torment me by calling my mother a witch?
I said no such thing.
I think that's quite enough discussion about the mask, Mary.
Wish.
Mary is simply not quite right in the head when it comes to you and your mother. When you were born, your father decided that there would only be one princess.
You
Your mother made Mary work as a servant in your nursery. They say the king never saw her faults. Which was he?
Do you think my mother was a witch?
I believe your mother was not right in the head either, like poor Mary.
So my mother was either crazy or a witch. Does that mean I will be too?
No, of course not.
Morning, Princess.
Where are the lilies that used to be here?
Princess Mary made us dig them out. As they were your mother's favorites.
You knew my mother?
Were you there? Or the beheading?
Tell me everything that happened.
I command you.
She was beautiful to the end and met her fate bravely. The king had sent for a French swordsman to make it quick and did his work.
So she did not suffer. She did not feel it.
Your mother loved roses, too. There might be some left at that end of the garden.
Thank you.
Can we slow down here? I'm being cut to shreds.
Father's in such good spirits since his triumph over France. When he sees how hard we have worked, I will be back in his good graces. This time I mean to stay there.
Who's there? How dare you? Elizabeth. And Robin Dudley, I should have known.
Was meant to be a surprise, sire.
Oh, my dear, you have succeeded.
It was my idea to restore these roses to their former glory, as you have restored the reputation of our country with your glorious win over France.
A pretty speech.
A loving tribute.
Elizabeth, bleeding from the thorns. Take care, dear child, for you are the true Tudor rose.
Sister, you should have come to me instead of questioning the servants about your mother. There's so much that I can tell you now that you are older. For instance, did you know that she was buried in a small chest? Somehow, Father forgot to order a coffin. The chest was too short for a normal person, but of course she fit in perfectly. They could put her head right in on top.
Elizabeth!
What is wrong with Elizabeth?
I do not know. We were just talking.
They have gone! You can open your eyes now.
Wasn't it wonderful? Even Father came to make sure I was all right.
Princess Mary sent these flowers. She stayed outside the whole time. She was so worried about you.
Huh. She was worried I would tell Father why I fainted. It must have driven her crazy. I mean, more than usual.
She's upset at the collapse of her marriage plans with Spain.
She is my only sister. And yet, I cannot trust her.
I never will. You call this working? You glaking edgepig! You wayward boiled brain! A fly-bitten mutton would have more done by now.
That is very impressive.
That is nothing. You should hear me when I really get angry.
Put your back into it, you plume pig mole. I will
bloody... Elizabeth!
I humbly beseech your majesty. Forgive my vile tongue.
She admits her vile tongue.
Father, you would be most forgiving indeed to overlook such blasphemy.
I heard no blasphemy. Beware the candied tongue that laps on royal boots and through its sugary slime conceals a black heart.
I demand behavior suitable to an heir from all my children. Do not try me again.
I am a year older now than when I began writing. I see that some things come easier now, like Latin and Greek. Some things are just as hard to endure, such as my constant craving for Father's attention.
After all our care last year, the roses are thriving.
Poor Father is not. Robin, I cannot face the thought that he may not be with us much longer. Edward is so young, there will have to be a regent until he comes of age, but who? Mary will be sure to put in her bed, and then Edward would be all that stands between her and the throne. At best, I will become invisible again. At worst, as long as I am near, you will remain safe. Never fear. Look, Robin, it's Mary. Some conspiracy is brewing, I have no doubt. Tell Edward we need him. Hurry!
Edward! Edward!
Come with me.
No, Robin!
It is wonderful to see you in better health, Father.
Is that what you call it?
It is true, you are noticeably improved. If only you would make the same effort to look after yourself as you lavish on the campaign against the French.
You criticize my conduct, Kate?
No, no, Your Majesty.
You contradict and lecture me. Enough!
I think only of your comfort. I humbly beseech your pardon if I have offended you. Please excuse me, sire.
The queen should study less and look around her. She is in danger of losing the king's favor.
Not Catherine Parr. She is perfect in all ways. What do you know?
It is said that the king is attracted to another.
Who is she?
A young widow with two sons. The king still hopes to sire male heirs.
Why can he not rest content with Edward?
Edward is often sick. The king has good reason to worry about his health and the succession.
And Mary and the lizard are always ready to feed his fears. No more queens will die in my father's court. Are you with me in this?
What news? The lizard has been given the right to search for heretics wherever he may find them, including the queen's own circle. Slowly undermining the king's faith and closing in on her.
ghost of Catherine Howard has come back. There are dark days ahead indeed.
Elizabeth!
The lizard has put Anne Askew to the rack.
He dares torture someone with such high standing among the court?
She is a known Protestant, but more important, she is a supporter of the Queen.
Kat, what is it?
Dr. Butts has given me terrible news. He came directly from treating the King, where he overheard him give the Lord Chancellor permission to arrest the Queen tomorrow.
We must warn her.
She is watched night and day by the lizard spies. No one may go in or out unobserved.
Except a doctor.
Surely they would suspect something. The Queen's not sick.
No. But you can send word via Dr. Butts that I am.
We fear the worst. It could be the plague. Go and leave me to attend the princess. Poor darling.
Guard the door, Kat. It is only powder.
What is the purpose of this charade?
You are in deadly danger. The King has signed your arrest warrant.
Oh. So it has come to this.
Save yourself. Run away, leave England.
Where would I hide from the King? No, I must fight to regain his love.
I cannot bear it if anything happens to you.
Oh, Elizabeth, you are very brave to have risked this for me. Daughter could love me more dearly, nor I her. Never fear, this contest is not lost yet.
What can she possibly be saying to him?
My lord and king, please excuse my intrusion. I have been reading.
You read too much. That's the problem.
Only the Bible of late, sire. Where Paul instructs women how they must be obedient to their husbands.
It is a pity you did not read it before.
Can one so close to God be merciful as well? My desire is to be taught by you in all things, most excellent and wise of princes. Oh, your legs.
Any man, if I become queen.
Since I began this diary, what has changed?
Catherine Parr is safe. Edward is still the heir. I have survived all kinds of plots against myself and others. I never once betrayed my own nature. I have earned your respect and love, Father. I'm giving it back to you tenfold. matter what happens when you are gone, I am no longer invisible.
Elizabeth remained with Catherine Parr when Henry VIII died. Edward reigned for 6 years until his death from illness. During her 5-year reign, Mary earned the name Bloody Mary for her violent efforts to return England to the Catholic faith. Elizabeth was never completely safe from her half-sister, who imprisoned her in the Tower of London shortly before her death. Elizabeth finally became queen in 1558. In the course of her 44-year reign, known as the Elizabethan era or the Golden Age, she transformed England into the richest and most powerful country in Europe. True to her word, she never married.